gang. Well, I did manage to make it go right and see Lexi play softball this week. That's the number one granddaughter. I have been wanting to see her all season and I haven't had a chance because, you know, the job and our own clients, my schedule is rather insane and time is at a premium. And in reality, I didn't really have the time to spare this time, but they were playing just the next town up from us, so really close. And I just didn't want to miss my opportunity to go see her play. So, I cheated. I got home from work on Thursday, changed really fast, grabbed some dinner on the run, and went and got to see her play. Took the video camera, and I have some footage for you. So, for those of you who aren't interested in watching an 11-year-old hit the ball and run the bases, then tune out now and come back and see me next week. Otherwise, if you're interested, here's how the game went. First of all, our team won. They did really good. They're getting so much better. Every year I've seen Lex in this age group play, they've improved. And her team is doing much better. I mean, they still made some mistakes, but these are young girls. These are, I think they're like 4th, 5th, and maybe 6th grade girls. Lex is 11. She's in 5th grade, and she's doing really, really well. She played this game, she played 3rd base at the beginning of the game. And then later on he moved her, the coach moved her into a couple of the outfield positions. They do tend to move them around at this age. I don't know if it's partially just to see where they fit in best or just to make sure everybody gets a chance to play. But I know they move them around a lot. In fact, we went through, I think both teams went through like 3 pitchers in the short amount of innings they play at this age. There's all kinds of unusual rules at this level. For instance, the play is not 9 innings like it is in regular professional baseball. It's, I can't remember how many innings, or a time limit. And, you know, whichever comes first, that's what calls the game. They also have a thing where you can only get 5 runs per inning. Even if you don't have any outs yet, they'll go ahead and switch sides. That keeps the game from being too horribly lopsided. So there's some unusual rules for the girls this age. For all I know, they do it for boys too. I have an all-girl granddaughter, so I don't know. Anyways, they did a really good job. They had us a little nerve-wracked for a while there because the other teams are doing really well, but we did win by, I think, at the end, 2 runs. And that's despite the fact that the umpire had some very questionable calls, let me tell you. I mean, he was calling some strikes where it was down by their ankles. The absolute worst, the batter's in the batter's box, the pitcher pitched the ball, the batter swung. But conveniently, the umpire had turned his head and was talking to somebody on the other team's side, so he didn't call it a strike. Even though it was a pure strike. No, I mean, she didn't even kiss the ball. It was a swing and a miss. But because he didn't see it, he didn't call it. And it was very, very frustrating for our little pitcher up there on the mound. She did still strike her out, but it was frustrating. Anyways, here's a clip that is classic Lex. She loves to steal bases. This is from her very first at bat. She got a good base hit, got her on to first base, and then she proceeded to steal second and steal third before somebody else at bat hit her, hit the ball and got her home because at that point it was bases loaded. So anyway, here's the clip. You can see how she did. All right, so there she is. She made it to first base with her base hit, and I apologize for the wind. It was an extremely windy day out there at the ball field, and it plays havoc with my camera. But there she is on first base, got her base hit. I didn't keep the telephoto on very long because the wind made my hands move a lot. So anyways, here's our next batter up, and well, she doesn't make a hit, but she does enable Lexi to steal second. Just watch and you'll see. Almost. She really loves tempting the other team. Tries again. No. Nope. And now we can make it all the way to second base. Now, what you can't tell in this clip, because I was focused on Lex, is that there was a runner on third during all of this. And that runner is still there. So it's making life a little difficult for Lex because she can't steal third base as long as the runner is on third base. You kind of see it, you saw a piece of her right there. Wants to try again, but nope. Big lead off the base. She's still stuck back there. There, you can see that third base runner again there, just coming into frame for a second. And now we got a hit, so the third base runner can make it in. Lex couldn't quite make it all the way home. She has to stay on third base. That's the team's coach there, of course. He's also the third base coach. Now, at this point, we have a runner on first and Lexi on third. Keep that in mind. Look at her. She wants to get in home so much.
Check it.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm fired upon on you.
All right, now what you couldn't tell is that batter just got walked to first base, so now we have bases loaded. And there we go. A good hit, got her in. And the second baseman rounds third and makes it in home as well. She has so much fun playing softball. She really does. Her mom is a nervous wreck. Her mom won't let her play pitcher. That's one position she won't let her do, even though Lexi wanted to, because she's just afraid of her getting hurt. This may be softball, but softball is a misnomer. Let me tell you, I've been hit in the temple with a softball. It's anything but soft. And these girls, they can sometimes hit that ball really hard, and occasionally it zings within inches of the pitcher. It's a little scary for a parent, I can understand. So I don't give her a hard time about not wanting Lexi to play the pitching position. Plus, that can be kind of rough on their arms, their shoulders. Especially at this age, I'm a little concerned about overuse injuries and things like that. But the main thing is that she has fun. I know that Jen's talking about having her maybe do some volleyball in preparation for middle school. Lexi goes to middle school next year, and maybe get her on the volleyball team. I think she could probably run track really well. She's really good with the running, especially the sprints, the short runs. And Jen herself was a superb track runner when she was a kid, and her hurdles were her specialty. So I'm thinking maybe track might also be a great sport for Lexi. Anyway, that's all for this time. Come back and see me.
See ya.
Come on, Lex.